waiting for our these benefits. Thank you so much. So yesterday was Friday the 13th, and it's considered to be an unlucky day, superstition. So yesterday they had screened all these scary movies on TV on a loop, and I started to watch them until the bliss because I am so fascinated by them. Even though they didn't show very good movies yesterday, so I will tell you about my first experience of watching one of the most scariest movies ever, The Exorcist. It was the first movie that I ever watched, first horror movie that I ever watched, and it was such a funny experience. So I was just 9 years old, and my sister was 11, and we watched it with another friend who was also our neighbor. And we had heard so much about this movie, and our parents had told us we don't want to watch it. You know, people like suffer from insomnia, people get heart attacks, they don't survive after watching this movie and all that. But we still wanted to see what the whole fuss was about. So we decided to rent the movie up, and we did not want our parents to know because we thought we would be going against their rules. So we went to the store, we rented this movie, we told our parents we were renting the Lizzie McGuire movie, which is absolute bullshit. So we got this movie, we decided to go watch it at my friend's house because her parents weren't in town. And while we were watching, my friend's elder sister walked in and she had seen the movie. So she was like, oh my god, I can't believe you're not even watching that movie, it is so scary. So that, you know, built a lot of fear within us, and we were like, okay, so should we go with this? Should we continue or what? So we were like, okay, why don't you sit with us since you've already seen the movie and tell us why the scary scene is going to come. So she's like, fine, I'll do that for you. She was a very bad person, like coaching or whatever. She was so mean. She did not tell us anything except for like stupid scenes. So anyway, so I think the scariest scene in that movie is when the girl who was also 11, so that's why my sister was a little more freaked out. So yeah, so she, in a fit of possession, she walks down the stairs and she's completely turned over and she opens her mouth full of blood. So, she did not, now my sister's friend, I mean my friend's sister did not tell us about that scene. So we did not see that coming, and all of us, the three of us were looking into the screen, you know, like, okay, what's going to happen next? And then, you know, suddenly this girl walks up and the three of us shriek, I swear, we all had our hearts in our mouth. It was so, so bad, okay, so scary. But the maid came running, she said, kya hua, what happened? And then we were like, nothing, go inside, because we were scared she would tell our parents. So then, we watched that scene and then we were like, okay, we can't watch more. And she's like, so then she felt bad for us. So she was like, okay, fine, I'll tell you. So then we watched the rest of the movie with a little more security. And finally, we finished it. And we were scared, but after we finished it, we were just so glad that we watched it. We really forgot about the fact that we were scared. So we were so happy because like we had accomplished something. So that night, now that's when the after effect actually started. So that night, when I was sleeping, now my sister and I shared a bed. And it just so happened that it had rained that night, and it was a really bad rain. There was lightning and there was thunder and everything possible that could scare us even more. And this is the funniest thing that has ever happened to me. So I woke up at like middle of the night, and like my eyes opened and it went directly on my sister's face. And lightning struck, and it struck like, you know, like how in movies when you strike and then, you know, someone's face will glow, whatever. So that was happening to my sister's face. So I got really scared, like turned around and I slept. And then I had a dream that my sister got possessed and she walked down the stairs. I think the next morning when I woke up, I was so terrified of my sister. I was like, you know, you have no idea what I saw, what you did in my dream last night. She was like, what did I do? And I'm like, one by one, I'm not looking at you ever again. I'm not sleeping in the same bed as you. I'm going to sleep with mom tomorrow. So that actually, you know, showed me that, okay, why my parents actually told me why I shouldn't have watched the movie probably at that young age. But it only made my love for horror movies even more, and I feel like the movies now are quite stupid. They're not as good as The Exorcist was. I mean, probably because I watched it at a younger age, but still. And as Mona mentioned in my introduction, I would love to have more parallel experiences.